Caribbean broadcasters set an example for the world to follow in the fight against HIV/AIDS. From its initial signatories of 30 to its current number at 104, the Caribbean Broadcast Media Partnership on HIV/AIDS has seen the number of broadcast partners across the region continue to grow. Inspired by a call to action under the Global Media AIDS Initiative by former United Nations Secretary General Kofi Annan, signatories in May 2006 acknowledged that the HIV/AIDS epidemic is a threat to humankind. The Caribbean comes second only to sub-Saharan Africa in HIV/AIDS prevalence. Initially, 30 regional media executives signed the Bridgetown Declaration. There are six regional media partnerships in the world under the umbrella of the GMAI, with just over 300 members. One third of them now come from the Caribbean. The CBMP has distinguished itself as an unprecedented coalition of major Caribbean commercial and public broadcast companies with one common goal: to use the power of the broadcast media to educate Caribbean people about protecting themselves from HIV, eradicating stigma and discrimination, and providing messages of hope. The partnership has achieved this outreach with the help of various international and regional partners. The partnership's now very recognizable Live Up campaign continues to highlight those in the Caribbean who have been positive forces in the fight against HIV. In early 2010, it released its latest campaign, This Is Me.
I do believe in justice, I do believe in equality, I do believe in mutual respect. One of the best things that you can do to protect yourself and to protect the other person is just to be honest and live up.
In addition, the CBMP rekindled its successful partnership with the International Cricket Council for another international sporting event. This partnership created a special Think Wise, Live Up public service announcement, which aired during the World 2020 competition. It was in a tragic turn of events on January 12, 2010, that the region's broadcasters realized that Live Up was more than just the campaign. It meant extending a helping hand to those surviving the Caribbean's worst natural disaster, the world's fourth most deadly earthquake in neighboring Haiti. While several partner stations organized national fundraising events, the CBMP executive director approached the Commonwealth Broadcasting Association to assist. Radio Netherlands sent Haitian partner Sikosida a radio station in a box. This helped to restore communication for Sikosida, reaching our members in Haiti, left almost without a voice. Despite the losses suffered by member stations and Sikosida, their commitment to the cause of CBMP is strong, and of the new members joining this year, the partnership welcomed five from Port-au-Prince. Garfield Burford, one of the hosts of Live Up the Show, visited Haiti and reported on the recovery process for Live Up Episode 3, the 2010 edition.
There's a flood of persons here who have descended upon this area to get medical attention, relief supplies in terms of water, and they're also going to execute a search and rescue operation to see if there are any persons alive here.
Three seasons of Live Up the Show have now been produced and distributed. A new season premieres every December to coincide with World AIDS Day. A training workshop was held for reporters from member stations who contributed to Live Up the Show. In addition, other training was provided for six journalists who were awarded the IAS fellowships by CBMP and fully sponsored by the partnership to attend the International AIDS Conference in Vienna, Austria in July 2010. With the assistance of Arkiva, these journalists attended pre-conference training at the Thomas Reuters Bureau in Vienna in partnership with the World AIDS Campaign. Trainers included the manager of the Media Center of the International AIDS Conference, a master trainer from Reuters, and experts from GNP+, ITPC, and CRN+, to provide the reporters with the tools needed to cover a conference of this magnitude.
Having been trained, I hope that I will take away with me enough knowledge that I'll be able to create some amount of behavioral change. And if I can do that and help to reduce the number of HIV infections in my country, then I would have won, courtesy of the CBMP.
The executive director and operations manager of the CBMP also attended the conference, with highlights available online at www.iliveup.com and, of course, the Live Up Facebook page. In the last year, this website was dramatically enhanced with the help of UNESCO, who funded the inclusion of a new information resource microsite accessible by everyone, but conceptualized and designed mainly for broadcasters. In addition, the website has had a growing fan base who can comment on, discuss, or share ideas about Live Up on Facebook. The Live Up campaign is using its website and new media as a means of reaching a wider audience and has become more interactive, helping target the section of the population the CBMP needs to reach the most, teens and young adults. Since its launch, the Facebook Live Up fan page and group combined attracted over 1,000 fans in 2 months. Producing and administering the Live Up campaign is only a small part of what this ever-growing broadcast partnership is all about. It's about sharing programming with other members so that the message reaches the widest possible audience. In the first half of 2010, two program packages were distributed to member stations, including Live Up the Show Elements for Radio, the Project Award-winning drama series by Antigua's Hama TV Paradise View, and a second season of the Barbados Ministry of Tourism drama Secrets, produced in collaboration with two members, were also distributed. The CBMP encourages stations to be creative and embed HIV and Live Up messages in programming. The annual Project Awards have since been reintroduced. One of the key successes this year, however, was the CBMP's outreach to key sectors who influence cultural values and responses. The CBMP recognized that in order to reach the widest cross-section of our audiences, it needed to go beyond the producers, the directors, and the scriptwriters of radio and television programming. Concert producers, popular entertainers, and DJs were successfully roped into the first Live Up Super Soundcheck. Cleverly using a necessary part of the setup for the Digicel Reggae Festival in Barbados, the concert soundcheck was used to promote valuable HIV/AIDS awareness messages.
What we try to do is to use the brand to educate Caribbean people,
yes,
Barbadians, Jamaicans, Trinidadians,
yeah,
about how they can make sure that they do positive action in the face of HIV/AIDS.
Sure.
Member stations will receive PSAs and program excerpts recorded at Super Soundcheck for broadcast. This was a groundbreaking partnership. The long-standing association with Digicel continues, providing HIV text messaging resources free of cost to those who wish information on local HIV resources. This partnership expanded this past year to include CBMP's involvement in the Digicel Rising Stars show by arranging for an HIV/AIDS-themed song to be written by Haiti's Micah, Tanya Stevens of Jamaica, Trinidad's Iwa George, and Barbados's Adrian Clark. This song was performed by finalists in these countries and will be shared with online VJs and their webcasts. For the third successive year, Scotiabank extended a helping hand with the CBMP's regional testing day.
And unless we shine a big magnifying glass and a big flashlight on this and bring resources, corporate resources and public resources, we're not gonna win the war.
Not only did the 2010 event occur in more territories, but in a show of unprecedented support, members of the faith-based community came out encouraging their congregations to get tested and know their status. With sterling leadership from the president of the Barbados Evangelical Association, the Reverend Dr. Nigel Taylor, 400 churches got fully involved.
I think we still need to pay a little more attention to the faith-based grouping because they're coming on board, but a little bit slowly. I think they're still not aware of what their role can be. So they need a whole lot more interventions. We've had seminars, we've had symposiums, but some of them are still not sure.
In 18 territories, a total of 8,000 people were tested, almost 3,000 more than in 2009. The partnership's knowledge and expertise was also shared with many other stakeholders. During the past year, the executive director made presentations at meetings of UNESCO, PANCAP, CCNAPC, and twice at UNIFEM. Being able to come face-to-face with the staff at member stations to explain the Live Up concept is important, and the CBMP continues its roadshows, which started in 2008. Now added to the list of countries visited are Grenada, Antigua, St. Vincent, and Guyana. The results of this work are heartwarming. In the most recent survey of members taken in June and July 2010, 82% responded that they were familiar with the work of the CBMP. 84% report that the Live Up brand resonates well with their audiences. 64.6% feel that the new Live Up Facebook and fan pages are effective, this after only 2 months of existence. 75.5% believe the CBMP UNESCO tool for media professionals is very useful. And 88% of broadcasters interviewed report meeting or exceeding their commitment of 12 minutes of HIV programming daily. Those who ask why more broadcasters from the Caribbean have pledged to join the fight than those from any other region will find that Caribbean broadcasters are very in touch with their audiences and know the true meaning of what it is to live up, to love, to protect, and to respect.